Hello and welcome to VitoshAcademy. Today we'll be talking about standard deviation with Python, because it is actually a really important and interesting concept in statistics and data analysis. So let's take a look at what we will be discussing. We'll be discussing this bell curve here, which comes from a code that I'm going to show later. And what is this standard deviation? Well, in simple terms, it's a measure of how spread out the numbers of a data set are from the mean or average. I mean, this is the mean and this is the standard deviation. This is one standard deviation between the black and the blue in both directions. So if the numbers are close to the mean, the standard deviation is small, which means that if the blue was really, really, really close to the black, it would have been a small standard deviation. And if the blue was somewhere here, then the standard deviation would have been large. Okay, so back to the point, when we talk about standard deviation, we refer to the bell curve, which is pretty much this one, and it's named standard distribution. So what is so standard about it? Well, there are like some rules about it. So 68%, I'm just writing, of the data is within one stdef. And I'm just going to make this one markdown so it's visible. And then 95% falls within two stdef. What does it mean? Just stopping quickly. It means that if this is all our population, so 68% of the cases are within either one to the left or one to the right of the blue, and 95 are two to the left or two to the right, and then that should be just writing it so it's better this better visually, and then we have 99.7% falls within three standard deviations. Okay, 68.0, I'm just going to put some zeros so it's better visible this way. They are not exactly zeros, they are something else, but let's keep it this way. 68.95, 99.7 is somewhere here. Yeah, and we still have some 0.3 that can be 4 or more to the left and 4 or more to the right. So what does it mean? This means that most data points are clustered around the mean with fewer and fewer points as we move further away. Yeah, makes sense. That's why this code actually a mean. Yes, so calculating the standard deviation, let's try to calculate it pretty much. This is the formula. So standard deviation is a small s equals square root of the sum xi, which are the data points, minus the mean squared. And this is over the number of data points. So yeah, makes sense. Let's imagine that we have some small data set like 4, 8, 6, 5, and 3. It's even random. And when I said small, I really mean small. Yeah, this one. Let's take the random of the mean of this one. What's the mean of this one? I remember it should be something with statistics. So import statistics, and here, would it work? Yeah, it worked. Okay, so this is the mean of this one, and then for each number we should subtract the mean and square the result. Okay. For number in let's see, data, statistics, data, for number in data, so for each number we subtract the mean and square the result. Yeah, makes sense. Number minus and then square this one to the power of 2. Squared. Let's print it just to see. Okay. Something like this. Yeah, makes sense. So for 4, the difference is this one, because 4 minus 5.2, so obviously 1.2, 1.2 squared is 144, and the rest are with the same. Okay, next find the average of these squared differences. Okay, so this one will be squared differences. And this one should be added into into a list. I'm just thinking how to do it, but something like this, squared differences, like that. And squared differences append squared difference. I'm just wondering whether this one would work, but let's see. Most probably not, but let's take a look. Well, it worked. Now they are in a list. Finally, take a square root of the average. So how do we take square root? Something with import mat, probably. Mat dot how do you probably mat dot sq T of 43, yes, this is how we get the square root. So we get to take a square root of the average. Average SQ diff equals statistics mean square the differences. And with other words, it's this one, 296. And we gotta take a square root of this one. Well, 1720465 and so on. So that's pretty much okay. Is there another way just to double check it? Of course there is, like everyone uses standard deviation, so we have it in NumPy, and it should be like np.std, which means standard deviation, not something else. And let's see data. And we got almost the same. Or what does it mean, almost the same? It's actually the same. Yes, literally the same. So this is the quickly the method for generating standard deviation. So we have the data, generate the data, get the mean of the data, here it would be create and and get the differences between, or let's see, no, for each number, subtract the mean and square the result, aka producing squared differences. Okay, we did this. Then finds the average of these squared differences. Makes sense. And take the square root of the average. Yep. Or use np.stddata. Yeah, pretty much this is the way to produce the standard deviation of the data. Makes perfect sense, I would say. So now let's take a look at the calculations and to see how we visualize standard deviation with Python. So this one would be interesting, but not so much because we only have five values. Five is really, really not a lot. So what do we have? We have NumPy, we have pyplotlib, and we have spicy stats. So generating a random data set. This is our data. Just showing you how the data looks. Pretty much quite random to me. But still, it produced a standard deviation. That's the tricky part. Calculate the mean and the standard deviation. Well, they don't use our methods here. They use this one, which is actually quite okay. Plotting the data, which means, hey, we have the X, we have the Y. And then creating a figure, making the figure beautiful with the labels 68, 27, 94, 45, 99, 73. That makes sense. You can put anything. I mean, here I have put 99.7. So it's 68, 27, obviously. 68.3, and here it would be 95.4, just to have it better. And this is how to make the lines like that. Mean plus standard deviation, this is exactly where we write them. And the line style looks pretty much okay, I would say. Blue, green, red, everything's quite nicely. So this is the standard deviation of some random things working. And you can see here how very few values, actually 99.73 minus 100, we have something like 0.27 or 0.26, both here and here. So it's close to nothing. Yes, and now let's think about real data applications. And here, I'll call this one real data applications. And of course, this one would be Markdown. Not that big, something like 1, 2, 3. Yeah. So real data applications, currently it's August 2024, so someone is selling shares or buying shares, like the whole internet is talking about it. So let's talk about something like it, like a data set of daily stock prices. So we are kind of interested into this, probably. I mean, half of the YouTube is talking about it. So let's take a look at the data to understand the volatility of the stock. So let's get some stock prices. coming out of the blue like this. 98, 105, 103, 110, 108, 107, and then they fall like 195, 93. Yeah, makes sense. So mean prices, we can either use statistics.mean or mpmean. In this case, we are going to use it this way, and then the standard deviation prices would be mp.std stock prices. Let's display both the mean prices. Yeah, makes sense, 101. And then the standard deviation. Well, 5 from the mean is one standard deviation. So you see, like here, we are almost 2. In a way, let's see if we go here 90, what will happen? Yeah, we had 2 standard deviations here when our shares, so say, ducked a bit. And if we want to be like, to make it nice, we can say something like mean is mean prices. And standard stdef is stdef prices. And then you should think what to do with all this information once you have understood it. Okay, so to recap, the standard deviation is really, really powerful tool to understand data spread. Pretty much you can understand here that standard deviation is actually 5.6. So this way you understand that the standard deviation is, I would say, consolidated, although it's 90 out of 101. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we calculated it manually using Python here. And we saw its application with real world data. So I really hope that you found this video helpful, and I hope that you like generally all the videos in VitoshAcademy helpful. If so, let me know. That's so far from me. Enjoy the rest of your day. Goodbye. Thank you.